Hey guys, Eddie the Magic Monk here. Welcome to another awesome SQL lesson. So what we found so far is that we've created a table, we've inserted some data, but what we found was firstly the phone number field, if I put a zero in front of the phone number, disappears, so that's not very good. And so today I want to talk about what you would do if you want to change the data type of a column and how you would add new columns to a table. So let's create a new query, and hopefully you would have saved all the queries that we've done previously. So create a new query, close this window, go to SQL View, and now what I want to do is type in alter table students, and I want to change the column called phone. And if you guys remember, we set it as an integer, which is the reason why it won't accept a zero in front. So I'm going to change it to character 10. So what that means is I can now enter in numbers as well as letters, and I can only have a size of 10 characters. So I can still have numbers less than that, but the space reserved for the cell is 10 characters. So yeah, let's run this query. So design run. Okay, make sure you close the students table, close it, and run it again. Okay, so I've just run the query. Nothing comes up to say you've run it, which is pretty funny. So if you go to students, and now if you type a zero in front of the phone, in front of a phone number, now notice how at the end there's a space. So if you delete that space and then go to the front and put a zero in, it'll work. So delete the space, go to the front, put zero in. Delete the space, go to the front, put zero in. And so now I have zero in front of the phone numbers. Now, let's say that I found the print balance table to be a bit pointless. So what I can do is I can also drop the table. So I can say, sorry, drop the column. So I can say drop column, and I can drop the print balance column. So I'm going to type in print balance, and if you run that, so close the table first, and if you run this query, right, it doesn't even say that you've run it, but once you run it once, if you open up the students table again, the print balance column is totally gone. So SQL is a bit dangerous, right? If you accidentally put this in and it's gone, there's really no way for you to get it back. Okay, there is no undo button or anything. So it's pretty dangerous. So be careful when you do this, please. Okay, so let's say I want to add a column. So let's go alter table students. Actually, let's save this query, save it as alter table students. Okay, and instead of dropping a column, I'm now going to put in add column. So add column, and let's put in a data type, field name. So let's add in their birth date. And the data type is going to be just date. Okay, so if I run that, let's run it. Again, you got to close the students table. One day I'll remember to do that. Run it. And then if you go into the students table, you can see you can now start entering some dates, right? And you can use the calendar. Let's put in, Oh, that's going to take a while, isn't it? Let's just put a random date, and then let's put in instead of 14, let's put in 99, right, and so on. Okay, so that's pretty much it for now. I will go through more stuff next lesson. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.